internet friends, and welcome back to Taboo Tuesdays, my favorite segment of the week where we tackle... This isn't a joke, I literally can't ever remember the tagline. Where we talk about things on Taboo Tuesdays that sometimes people don't know how to ask about, or want to ask questions and feel weird about it, or ask questions even if they feel weird about it. So we're going to talk today about something that had never crossed my mind before I was going to become an amputee. What do we call this? How do we refer to this without offending people? You may notice I'm wearing my handy dandy reference chart today, thanks Gus Johnson for this awesome shirt, I adore it. What's okay to say, what's not okay to say? Now let me just begin by saying I am not the word police. I don't really believe in being the word police, and I'm not gonna be offended by whatever you call it. In fact, people have said, oh, so many things online about me and about it, and whatever you want to refer to my stump, nubbin, residual lib, whatever, by it works for me. But I'm gonna go over sort of just a general overview of how the amputee community looks at missing parts of your body and how to refer to those as. If you want to avoid possibly offending anybody, pre-amputee life for me, this was, again, something I never really thought about. I always just thought of, like, if someone was missing their arm, like, that part would be called a stump, right? Like, that's just what I'd always heard. I don't know if that's what you guys always heard. Side note, real quick, if you would let me know what you think this should be called, and again, I don't take offense at anything around this topic, let me know what you've always thought, what you always referred to amputated limbs, residual limbs as. As I went down the path of researching what being an amputee would actually look like, I joined some Facebook groups, which were super, 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 super helpful. I realized pretty quickly that not everybody said stump, and that actually some people were offended by that. The medically appropriate term is residual limb. I guess it makes sense. Logically, it's like the residual part of a limb. That is what medical professionals are supposed to refer to that part of your body as. My experience has been that doctors will absolutely still say stump. I know that that is actually deeply offensive to some people in some forums and groups. I know that it's like hurtful to some people. They don't want that part of themselves referred to in a crude manner. They prefer the medical terminology, which I completely and totally understand. Now, personally, I don't care. It's just not something that has affected me either way. So I usually just call it my, like, nubbin. It just looks like a nubbin, doesn't it? It's just like a little, it's a nub of something. It's my little leg. It's what I have left. I almost hesitated to make this video because we live in a world of censored words, right? Where a lot of words are offensive, and sometimes people feel like it's hard to keep up with, like, what's offensive and what you can and can't say. And I'm definitely not here saying you can or can't say anything. I'm just here to say that for some people, residual limb is the safest way to go. So if you run into someone in public and you find yourself about to say stump in a sentence and you think, wait, I don't know this person, I don't know their history, residual limb is probably the safest way to go. So there you go. If you ever, you know, spent sleepless nights wondering what you should call an amputee's missing body parts that are still attached. English is my first language, I'm just still not super good at it. Since we're talking about learning new things today, I would like to introduce you to one of my favorite services online, Skillshare. Now, I've talked to you guys about them before, but they are who I use to learn new things. I've used other services before, there are other versions of kind of like online classes, online schools that you can take, but I really like Skillshare because they have awesome, talented, easy to understand teachers, and the classes are really well structured, and there's great projects to work on, and there's discussions in the classrooms, and I have found it a really great way to learn new skills. For instance, editing is something that I've been trying to get better at, trying to work on. In a recent film that I worked on about Come Back to Me into the Field where I lost my leg, I went on Skillshare to learn a little bit more about Final Cut Pro 10 because I wanted to do a good job with that film. I'm gonna link it down below, by the way, because I'd love it if you check it out. I'm kind of really proud of it. I feel like a little kid about that. Like, I'm excited that I got that done. Skillshare has a library of classes and courses that range just about any topic that you can think of. I have taken it on creative writing, public speaking, editing, filming, cinematography, like anything that I'm interested in. And the cool thing is that it's all included for one price. So if you click the link down below, it will not only support this channel, but it will also get you 2 months free of Skillshare, which is what I did the first time I tried it, because don't want to spend money on something until I know that I like it. And even then, it's only $10 a month. So thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. And thank you guys for listening to me explain how residual limb stump nubbins / fill in the blank should be referred to. It really means so much to me that you spent a few minutes of your time here with me today. Now, if you're an amputee, I'm curious what your favorite or least favorite term is. Maybe there are other ones that are more creative and cool that I haven't even heard of yet. Let me know in the comment section down below. I love you guys, I'm thinking of you, and I will see you in the next video. Bye guys. Hey.